Welcome back. Of course, you're still locked in. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And if you saw the queue, you know what time it is. We're talking about health. And now a preliminary study has suggested that the Oxford University AstraZeneca vaccine that arrived in South Africa earlier this month provides only limited protection against mild to moderate cases of the South African variant of the coronavirus. Now, South Africa has now halted the rollout of the vaccine and await the arrival of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine instead. And our infectious disease specialist, Dr. Emil Reed, who's a local on the show right now, is joining us in the studio to tell us more about the different coronavirus vaccines. And if you have any questions, you are more than welcome to call us. And the number is 021-110-5552. That's 021-110-5552. And we'll be taking your calls and answering a few of your questions later on the show with the doc. But firstly, doctor, how are you doing this morning, man? Thank you
good
for joining
morning,
us.
Good morning, guys. Always great to be here.
Always good to have you enlighten us with all your knowledge, of course. And we've got so many questions.
So much. I think now it's gotten to a point where it's a little bit confusing, doctor. I mean, South Africa received 1 million doses of the Oxford University AstraZeneca vaccine from India not too long ago. You know, but what is it exactly? What is this vaccine and how does it work?
Yeah.
Guys, it's an amazing vaccine. Mm. You know, the AstraZeneca vaccine is what we call a DNA vaccine. And what it does, it actually uses other viruses not found in humans, chimpanzee or macaque adenoviruses, and it connects DNA or proteins of the virus to that specific virus, the adenovirus. And that virus is being used as a vehicle to be injected into the human body, which then produces certain proteins that elicit an immune response. And those proteins that are on the adenovirus of the macaque actually are those proteins associated with a spike protein of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, elicit the immune response, which actually protects us against the COVID-19 virus infection.
Okay.
And the importance of a vaccine is that different vaccines do different things. Certain vaccines protect you from acquiring an infection. Certain vaccines protect that infection from being transmitted to other people. And also certain vaccines only protect people against severe diseases associated with an infection.
Wow. So, I mean, you mentioned that obviously after hearing that this is an incredible vaccine. I mean, it's doing amazing things. The fact that it's been formulated so quickly is almost like groundbreaking. If anything, why then is this becoming such a big problem and not a solution in our country? Why are we having all these issues with the vaccine?
Well, I think for all of us, last year was like a honeymoon period with the development of vaccines. Mm-hmm. And the reason why vaccines were developed so rapidly is because the expertise was there, the knowledge was there, the building blocks for these vaccines, the technology was available. So the only thing people needed to do was to actually use the genome of this virus and apply everything that they already know to develop these vaccines.
Okay.
So the AstraZeneca vaccine was tested and trialed in Brazil, in the UK, in the US, found to be extremely efficacious. And when we tested it towards the end of last year in South Africa, it was tested around about 2,000 young people, average age of about 31. And it was found to not be efficacious in that specific group for mild to moderate disease at all. The question we don't know is the effect of the AstraZeneca vaccine on severe diseases, hospitalization, and deaths. So it might still have a place, although currently you cannot use the AstraZeneca vaccine to vaccinate everybody, or even the healthcare workers in South Africa, because the chances of them having mild to moderate disease is extremely well, and the chances for them to have severe disease in that age category is extremely low.
Yeah.
So the variance that is currently circulating in South Africa and also in Britain is in all likelihood responsible for the curveball with regards to the AstraZeneca vaccine.
Very briefly, Doctor, we just want to get into the effectiveness of this vaccine currently, especially against the South African variant of COVID-19.
Well, in South Africa, it's been shown probably to be about 10% efficacious for mild to moderate COVID-19 disease. If one look at the previous variants, the wild type virus, for instance, it was between 85 and 95% efficacious. And that's a big problem. And just remember, the longer we allow COVID to continue, the more spreading takes place, the more error-prone this virus become, the more mutations will develop, the more unfortunate resistance we might see.
Well, Dr. Reed, I can't thank you enough. Of course, we are going to be continuing this conversation with you guys. We're talking about all things vaccine, the coronavirus pandemic, and we'll be updating you on everything that you have. So don't forget, you can send us all your questions through on that line that is available. You can see it on your screens right now. So call us in, and the doc will, in fact, be answering your questions later on the show, and we'll be chatting to him. But before we get to that, let's see what's happening with Cheese. Got something latest?